Yo, right, so I thought I'm gonna do something a little bit different, okay? So we have now, it's very echoey because there's no furniture. Me and Jack have completely finished this rewire. So what I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna show you the finished job, okay? From what we came from to what we are, well, what we've left with now. And I'm gonna have a little chat with Jack about, which he doesn't know about, he's literally just walked in. Whoa, spin you around. Can have a little chat with Jack about his actions and how he's found the job, what he's preferred about it, what he's found tricky, what he wants to learn more about and all the rest of it. But yeah, so bear with and we'll catch up with you in a second. When we came to this job, we weren't here for any electrics, okay? So we weren't down for that. So, but the plastering's already been done downstairs, and when we looked into it, needed rewiring. So that's, it is what it is. Okay, so we used Tradeify for sorting all the invoicing and estimates and all that sort of stuff. So now it's actually worked really, really well. So like I say, just go and check them out. So right in here, it was all discussed. They don't want any of the socket positions changing. They don't want any of the heights altering, things like that. So they're all lower than what a regulation height for building regs, which is part M of the building regs. So like I say, me and Jack rip round. Yo, so right, I've discussed with the client, everything's staying it where it is. So socket heights and stuff are still low because regulation now is 450 to the bottom and 1200 to the top, which is part M of your building regs. So to try and cause as minimal damage. So this room hasn't been plastered yet because what I actually came here for was to get in this chimney fireplace that's coming out and then stuff to do with the kitchen, but it turns out it needs rewiring. So me and Jack have been, and Lewis to be fair, we're running around and putting all the sockets in and trying to cause as minimal damage as possible. So as you can see, this room's already been skimmed out. So when we came here, it was a little bit messy. So what we always like to do is make sure that when we're leaving the job, it's all swept out, even though it's nothing to do with us. I mean, let's face it, we're not gonna go polishing everything, but it's a lot tighter than when we first came. And we've already agreed with the customers that they want to get rid of the rubbish rather than us doing it. So that's all bagged up, ready to go. And it's a lot of the rubbish that's not actually ours, but it's just tidy now. So yeah, so that's that. So that's upstairs, quickly ripped round there. We've also put two-way lighting in for upstairs and downstairs because it didn't have that. And I thought, well, I'm just gonna do that part and parcel of the job. Now in here, this is part of the other job here, okay? So we've got a lot of the kitchen stuff to all renovate and go on that we coming up in future videos on there. And then under the stairs is where all the consume units are. So we've got two in here. We've got your mains for the house, this bit, and then that's the heater one. So what I'm gonna do, let's get the camera set up and we will have a chat with Jack and see what he's learned and what he has forgotten. Right, hopefully you can see us clear enough. So Jack, what has been tricky on this job, do you mind?
What was tricky? The first pendant I did, that's quite hard because it's just knowing where the cables go.
It's
pretty hard.
It's because you don't really do many of them, do you? Because it's always like Jack's very confident in doing all your sockets and things like that, so you run around. So we tried to make, there's actually videos that you might have already seen of Jack actually doing it from start to finish on there. So that was a good one, to be honest, wasn't it, on there? So what have you enjoyed the most? What he's pointing to, let's take you in and show you, okay? So Jack is pointing to his consumer unit, so which is this little bad boy, okay? So if you come in here, Jack. So I'll try and hold it so Jack can see as well. So what have you enjoyed about that, Jack?
Literally just all of it. I've really enjoyed doing consumer units because it's just like making them neat.
Yeah.
It's just, I just think it's really satisfying. and I do enjoy it.
Did you do, so how did you bring the cables in on that?
Well, so they come down here, and then so I drilled three holes in the back, and then...
they were just underneath the din rail, weren't they?
Yeah, just underneath, yeah, and then I brought them up through here, and then all I really did was, so I brought all the neutrals and nerves up from all the cables first, and then dressed them in. And literally, because it's just, they just come up here, and then you peel them all the way back, and they just come up, and that's really it. So I've got I've got a row of neutrals and a row of earths coming up there.
Yeah.
And then that's really it. And then all you do with the lives is you just bring them up and cut as much as you need, and that's it.
So what I'll do is I'll put a picture up around somewhere on here to show you the inside of this. So basically what Jack's done as well is like he's put them on standoffs, so there's a void behind the consumer unit so you can get all your cables in.
Yeah.
But in fairness, not just saying it because the Ginger Warrior's here, he's actually done a really, really good job, and nice and neat. And the key is, do I put loads of pressure on you, Jack, to get it done quick?
Yeah.
No, because that's the key, is if I'm on Jack's back, you go, come on, get this done.
I'm just not panicking.
You are, you're going to panic, and yeah. I don't work very well like that. I don't know anybody else who does. And if you do work like that, then you've obviously got bigger mental issues than me. I prefer to do positive sort of attitude and reinforcement rather than anything else. Have I started doing anything with questions, Jack?
Yeah, it's firing questions at me. So it's more of like the testing side,
yeah,
of stuff. Because that's like the proper complicated stuff.
Yeah,
but I mean, it's starting to just set in.
This is the thing, so I never had any of this. So what I've tried to do with Jack is I've just, which you guys don't know yet, but I have just been made up to approved contractor for the NIC, EIC, which is something they've been telling me to do for the past 15 years, and I just kept putting it off and off and off. And somebody made a comment recently, which it annoyed the living daylights out of me, and said, I'm not a real Sparky because I'm only a domestic installer. Well, you can't be this, you can't be that. And I don't like people telling me I can't do something, I can't be this and I can't do that. So I've just gone, whatever, mate. I've just done it for the sake of it, just to shut someone else up. So when we change our work gear, as we get more and more knackered for these, you'll see all that on there. So what I'm trying to do with that is, on my assessments, you always get asked questions about regs and things like that, and that's what I've been working on with you, isn't it? It's just trying, making sure and prepping Jack, because when I'm on my assessments, because I've got anxiety and things like that, I'm generally just on my own, and I always have my own assessor. So I'm trying to prep Jack, so on the next assessment that perhaps I'll have Jack with me, so he can be questioned and he knows certain things, although they're not expecting Jack to know the answers, but it'd be nice for Jack to have those things. So always taking your time, if you have got an apprentice, is take your time to do that. They're not cheap labour. I don't want you as cheap labour, I've never have done. It's always trying to make Jack better than me, that's what I want, because I'm getting old, and I'm not going to be able to do this forever. So if I can pass the details and knowledge on, that's key. So worst part about this job, do you think, Jack?
The worst part about the job.
This has been a pretty rewire.
It's been. I wouldn't say there's been a bad.
It for me.
It was pretty straightforward.
The worst bit, I suppose, is going in the lofts, isn't it? That's got to be the worst part. But that's not too bad now, is it?
Yeah, no. I genuinely don't think lofts are that bad.
No, Jack generally goes in the lofts more than me now. I don't really bother too much because I'm not stupid. And that's why I've got Jack. Cheap labour, that's what we want.
As long as I've got a mask.
Yeah, it's a mask, isn't it? Yeah, mask on, and then put the uni lights up, and everyone's a winner. It's comfortable then. So that's basically, so for here, this is literally the dream rewire, because we've got voids under the floors, we've got all this, that, and the other, and it's nice and easy. So like I say, I think this is, as far as rewires go, they don't get much better than these. Empty house, no carpets, no furniture. Real bonus really for us. So just wanted to make a quick little video from me and Jack, just about obviously the final tour of this job. and answer a few questions. So if there is going to be, I know I keep saying it, there is going to be a video on the van. The video that you should have already had gone up by now, there's a little sneak peek on the video in the last one about obviously the van and things like that, so go and check that out. But yeah, so from me and Jack, thanks very much for watching, and if you haven't subscribed, please make sure you hit the link in the corner, give us a thumbs up, leave your comments, and we'll try and get back to those as quickly as we possibly can. Cheers, guys.